Sunset Crater is rare in that basaltic scoria cones typically don't erupt so violently. So we were really curious to know why Sunset produced such a high plume and erupted with so much force. So how exactly do you calculate the height of a plume from a past eruption? We dig pits all around the old volcano and look at the layers of different tephroclasts and separate them based on density and size. Why do we do this? Well, the eruption plume of a volcano rises in the air until the density of the plume and that of the surrounding atmosphere are equal. This is called the neutral buoyancy height, where the plume stops rising vertically and instead starts spreading laterally. It's kind of like a diver who carries weights to equalize the buoyant force that is pushing him upward. The ash cloud spreads laterally in a circle. The larger, denser tephroclasts fall out first, closer to the column, while the finer, less dense clasts are carried further. The distance the clast travels depends on the speed of the wind and the height of neutral buoyancy. The largest clasts in the pit are important. Once you find those, you can draw lines connecting all the clasts of one size and get a bullseye pattern that shows how much ash there was, how far the cloud traveled, and ultimately, how high the ash cloud rose up into the air. In the case of Sunset Crater, we found that the plume rose up to at least 20 kilometers and the ash traveled at least 20 kilometers from the vent. Not so different from the Mount St. Helens eruption in 1980. It's a complex puzzle, but calculating the height of the plume and the force associated with the Sunset Crater eruption was an important first step. The next step is to understand the plumbing system. What happened before and during the eruption inside the volcano itself that caused it to be so violent?